thank you for being here today and to hear from autoworkers who have come here with a message. I'm here with a group of autoworkers from Michigan, Indiana, Ohio, New York, and Delaware, who have traveled to our nation's capital to express the views of working people on the current crisis. We are active workers and retirees, past and present elected officials. We come from Ford, we come from Chrysler, GM, part suppliers such as Delphi, Allison, and American Axle. I myself retired after 32 years at General Motors, having worked as an assembler, as a pipe fitter, and having been elected by my peers to represent my local, UAW Local 909, as both its president and chairman. And I did serve a stint as an international representative of the GM department at Solidarity House in Detroit. And just in case you're wondering, we did not fly in on private jets. During the presidential election, much concern was expressed for Joe Sixpack and the so-called middle class. We were described as hardworking Americans who played by the rules. And now that the election is over, we're being blamed for the problems confronting the Detroit Three as if we're at fault for the unprecedented sharp drop in domestic auto sales. We reject this. The blame lies directly with the reckless behavior of Wall Street and the politicians who have removed all constraints on their unbridled greed. We believe the power that has driven the successes of our economy has been America's unionized workforce due to the wages and benefits that we have won through collective bargaining. The gains we have won as part of the United Auto Workers Union hasn't just benefited us. They have supported our communities, small businesses, and have even set the living standards for our non-union brothers and sisters in the Sun Belt. We urge Congress to endorse the bridge loan immediately, although we reject the notion that auto workers must make further concessions for its approval. Talk of more givebacks by our union ignores the cuts we made just 1 year ago when our union agreed to a 50% wage cut down from $28 an hour to $14 an hour and no pensions for new hires. Reducing our quality of life will have a ripple effect on our entire economies and will just make things worse. The reality is that our labor constitutes just 8% of the price of a new car. We could work for free and it wouldn't solve the crisis. Much has been made of the cost disadvantage to the Detroit Three of my health care and that of hundreds of thousands of retirees. When we are compared to the foreign nameplates in the South, no mention is made that the reason for the difference is that their plants in the Sun Belt have no retirees to speak of. They are new plants. General Motors just celebrated its 100th anniversary. Instead of reducing or delaying the company's liability to us as retirees for our health care, we have a better idea. In 2005, GM agreed during a special negotiations with the UAW to pursue national health care solutions, modeled possibly on the health care system in Canada. We believe now is the time for big solutions and not for further attacks on workers. We are here to advocate for the passage of my Congressman John Conyers' Medicare for All Bill, H.R. 676. Its passage will bring us to the same level as the rest of the developed world. It will level the playing field for the Detroit Three with the domestic competition of Toyota, Nissan, Mercedes, and so on. And it will finally provide medical insurance to the millions of fellow Americans who do without. And with that, I thank you very much for your attention.